Hello friends, welcome to OliveBot. I hope you're all doing well and your exam preparations are going good too. In this video, we are discussing the 50 most important computer awareness questions. Now, these questions are very important for RRB mains examination, for NABARD development assistant examination and various other government and banking examinations. So we will be covering this through two parts, which is part 1 and part 2. This particular video is part 1 of the series wherein we are covering 25 most important questions. Before we get started with the video, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest videos. The first question is, a computer cannot boot if it does not have the what? So one of the following is the correct answer. And it is option C, that is operating system. So if a computer does not have an operating system, it cannot boot. The second question, the process of starting or restarting a computer system by loading instructions from a secondary storage device into computer memory is called what? So it is a process through which we either start or restart our computer system. So all the instructions are loaded from a secondary storage device. What is it called? The correct answer is option 2, that is booting. What does the disk drive of a computer do? Or what it does? So out of the following, the disk drive has a particular function to be done, and the correct answer is option 4, which is both B and C, that is the disk drive reads what is it the content of the disk, and it also loads the program from the disk to the memory of the computer. The next question, when you turn on the computer, the boot routine will perform this test. So when we turn on the computer, there is a test that runs in the computer. What is it called? The correct answer is option 2, that is disk drive test. Bandwidth refers to. So we know bandwidth is too much into news nowadays. So what does the term bandwidth refers to? And the correct answer is option D, which is the amount of information a communication medium can transfer in a given amount of time. So how much ever communication is or information is transferred or communicated from one medium to another at a particular time is called the bandwidth. So when we talk about internet, bandwidth is a major term. If the computer keeps rebooting itself, it is likely that. So if a computer is continuously rebooting itself, what can be an effect of that? The correct answer is option 1, that is it can be affected with virus. So if a computer is affected with virus, it keeps rebooting itself. Devices that enter information and let you communicate with the computer are called. So one of the following is a device that lets us communicate with the computer and also helps us enter information. What is that? The correct answer is option 4, which is input devices. So input devices helps us enter information, and by entering information we can communicate with the computer. The next question, the computer connected to a LAN, which is local area network, can do what of the following? So if we connect a computer to the local area network, what is the result that we get? Through that we can share information and also share peripheral equipments. So the next question, which device cannot be shared in network? Out of the following, there is one device that cannot be shared in network, and the correct answer is option 2, which is a mouse. The person who writes and tests computer program is called what? So a person who writes and tests the computer program is called a programmer. DNS is the abbreviation of what? So out of the following, there's one correct answer, which is domain name system. So DNS stands for Domain Name System. Which of the following is not a type of computer facility? So out of the following, there's one which is not a part of computer facility. And the correct answer is option C, which is dedistributed. Because they're decentralized or centralized or distributed are all a types of computer facility. Computer network is a... Which of the following is the correct answer? So a computer network is basically a distributed data processing system and multiple computers are linked together for the purpose of data communication and resource sharing. So a network of computers helps us distribute data processing system and also helps us in data communication and resource sharing. Hence, both A and B are true. Which of the following will be used for checking spelling? So if we have any spelling errors, which of the following helps in checking that? The correct answer is option one, which is dictionary disk. Internet banking is an example of... So one of the following is a correct answer. It is electronic fund transfer. So we know that whenever we are conducting or when we are doing internet banking through our mobile phones or computers or laptops, we are electronically transferring funds from our account to some other account. Anonymous FTP is what? So one of the following is the correct answers. Anonymous FTP is Internet File Transfer Protocol. So through file transfer protocol, we can transfer files anonymously in the presence of internet. The CPU performs read or write operations at any point of time in what? So these are all the memories. So the CPU, which is central processing unit, performs the operations of reading or writing in what? The correct answer is EEPROM. Now, if you have not read about memory or if you want to check that, we are providing a link in the description box as well as in the end screen. We have for you few computer awareness videos that we have created for you. Please go through those videos and make sure you are completely exam ready. BIOS is an abbreviation for. So one of the following is the correct answer, which is binary input or binary output. Most common channel used by networks today is what? So it is one of the following, and what is the correct answer? Now, if you also want to read about computer awareness, we have a ebook for computer awareness, the link of which is also provided in the description box. This is the PDF link. You can go and download the PDF from the description box. If you want to take up more tests or answer more questions of this sort, you can also log into our Olivebot website to log into that and to give many mock tests for all the examinations that you're preparing for. You can just register with us and give free All India mock tests. So for this particular question, the answer is telephone lines. Now, many of us may get confused by answering internet because we may think that the most common channel which is used by networks is internet. But telephone lines are more than the internet. What is the product of data processing? So whenever we process data, what is the product or the end result of that? The correct answer is information. So data is the first thing which gets processed and information is the output from that. What is a microprocessor? So what is the function of a microprocessor from the options given to us? The correct answer is a microprocessor is a small device that controls other equipments. The next question. What are the concentric circles on floppy disks known as? So whenever we see a floppy disk or a floppy disk, so it has concentric circles, which is known as tracks. What is Kimball tag? So one of the following is the correct answer, which is an addressed label. So now when we see these QR codes, right, which are also the labels for addresses. So if we click a picture or try to scan the QR codes, we can go to an address. The same way through Kimball tags also, we can reach out to some other things. So this was many years ago that we had. Dot matrix is a type of, and here the correct answer is option B, which is printer. So it is a type of printer. A dash is a computer connected to two networks. So what is the correct answer from the following options? It is a bridgeway. So a bridgeway is a computer that connects two networks. That's all we have for you in this video. I hope you liked the video. Please do share it with your friends and keep them updated with the computer awareness. If you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, please subscribe now to stay tuned to Olivebot and not miss any video from us. All the very best for your examination and hope to see you soon. Thank you.